Now listen. Let me come back to emotion retention and emotion fermentation. You get multiple types of emotions, almost all emotions every day. Sometimes lust, sometimes greed, sometimes fear, sometimes the multiple versions of fear, sometimes worry, sometimes love, sometimes attention giving, sometimes attention asking, sometimes jealousy, sometimes comparison, various emotions, sometimes the willpower, sometimes arrogance, sometimes frustration, different emotions I can describe. All kinds of emotions you get, but logically, through your conscious decision, the thought currents or emotions which you cherish stays inside you and starts getting fermented. The good news is, no emotion gets fermented inside you. No fermentation of emotions happens inside you without your conscious support. You should understand that. I still remember somebody came to Isakki Swami and said some of his problems. When he was describing, Isakki Swami sat silently and he was listening. That is one of the most beautiful way he used to attend to people. He will wait so peacefully, in his presence used to be very heavy. The corner of the room, he will be sitting on the wooden plank, one wooden plank as the back support and one wooden plank on which he will be sitting, just with kaupin, lion cloth. Fortunately, the kamandalu he used and those few items are still with us. He has given it to me. And it is all still with us, his energy and his presence. The conch he used. And anyhow, listen now. Let me tell my love story with my gurus later. Now let me give you the knowledge, the experience. With my gurus. When I start talking about my gurus, I became like a Hindu priyal. Chennai Indu Priyal, if you talk to her, she will never talk about any of my teachings or anything. She will be all talking about me. And sometimes when I talk about my gurus, I also become like her. So let me tell all the teachings of my gurus. So he was so peaceful and heavy in his presence, intense. That person who was telling his problems, he himself understood the source, the core of his problem, and he blurted out, "Orama unnalatta samiye vaalkaiyila ella perachanaiyum adhi en vaalkaiyai azhikkudhu sami." I'm trying to recollect exact words. Then Isakki Swami heard patiently and used to have that small slate and chalk piece. He gave that to that devotee and asked him to write that main word, Porama. The devotee wrote Porama. Isakki Swami just took the slate and just put one arrow mark the other way and asked him to read reverse. So if you know Tamil, you can write Poramai and read it reverse.
I'll tell you exactly in Tamil. Some devotee came and started telling their problems to Isakki Swami. He heard everything patiently detailed. He was so peaceful. The devotee himself has found why the problems are in his life, what is his real problem and what is the core pattern, why he is creating so much of problems in his life. Finally, he clicked that jealousy is the problem. So he told in Tamil that Poramai is the word for jealousy in Tamil. That is the real problem I am having. He uttered that word. Then Isakki Swami asked him to write that word in Tamil, in the slate. The devotee wrote. Isakki Swami just put the arrow mark the other way and asked him to read that word backside, the reverse. If you read the word for jealousy in Tamil, poramai, in reverse, it is like a curse word. The moment the devotee read, he smiled and said, he just threw the hand gestures, he expressed, porama angadhaan kondu pogum. Jealousy will take you to the space where you are cursed. That is what will happen. I tell you, from that day, the devotee consciously stopped supporting his jealousy. So within few weeks, the fermentation of jealousy has stopped inside him. So all the decisions he makes due to the fermentation of jealousy has collapsed. Within 1 or 2 months, he came out of all the problems and he became all right and successful in the life.